Hi there, I'm Sierra from Western Digital Support, and in this video, we're going to continue with troubleshooting the MyCloud OS5 device offline message. In the previous video, we tried basic troubleshooting. If that didn't work, let's move on to recreating our RAID volume. We'll begin by taking steps to see if drive 1 and volume 1 exist or not. Then, we'll back up the drive and recreate the RAID volume. Let's get started. Begin by accessing your admin dashboard and log in as the admin user. You can do this by opening a web browser on your computer or mobile device connected to the same network as the MyCloud device. Type in the IP address of the MyCloud device into the address bar of the web browser to access the device's dashboard. Log into the dashboard with your admin username and password. Select Storage and then click RAID. Next, ensure that drive 1 is not missing or failed if in JBOD mode. Also, make sure that drive 1 has a capacity larger than 100 gigabytes and is not 100% filled to capacity. Before we go any further, it's critical that you back up any data to another device to ensure that no data is lost during the next few steps. After backing up your data, we'll recreate the RAID volume. Begin by logging into the dashboard using your admin credentials. Select Storage and then click RAID. Select Change RAID Mode, located below RAID Volume. A warning message will appear, letting you know that this process can interrupt any file transfers to or from your device. Click OK to continue. Select your desired RAID mode and click on the checkbox. You may see more or less options, depending on if your device is a 2-bay model or a 4-bay model. Click Next to continue. A drive test will begin. Wait for this to complete, and when the status appears as good, click Next. An option will appear, allowing the drives to be encrypted. Choose your preferred option, and then click Next. A summary of the chosen configurations will display to make sure that the desired options were selected. Click Next to proceed. When you're ready to reformat the drives to change the RAID, click Finish. The final message will appear providing information on the formatted drives and which RAID they are now in. Click Close to complete the process. And that's all it takes to recreate the RAID volume on your MyCloud OS5 device. Now, let's cover how to check for network jitter and latency. High amounts of latency and jitter can result in network reliability or connectivity issues. To check for this issue, we highly recommend visiting fusionconnect.com/speed-test-plus, or using a network test tool. You can access that link in the description below. If you find that you have high amounts of jitter and latency, you should address the issue with your network router and upstream internet service provider. Now let's check the network router's universal plug-and-play settings and the IP address of your MyCloud device. Universal plug-and-play allows networked equipment, like your computers, printer, and MyCloud device, to seamlessly discover each other's presence on the network. Universal plug-and-play is intended primarily for residential networks. To check the router's assigned IP address for the MyCloud OS5 device, log in to your router as admin and check your connected devices section. Also, go to the port forward, NAT, or network address translation, or universal plug-and-play section of your router to determine the internal and external universal plug-and-play port assignments. Finally, make sure that the universal plug-and-play option is turned on. This will allow your router to automatically assign a port for the MyCloud device and make it visible on the network. If your device is still offline, proceed to the next video in the series. We hope this video was helpful. For more how-tos and tips, visit us online at westerndigital.com/support. Thanks for watching.